Srimati Aparupa Poddar.
Sir, I rise to speak on the Indian Forest Amendment Bill 2017. The bill has replaced the Indian Forest Amendment Ordinance promulgated by the President of India on 23rd November 2017. Sir, the Indian Forest Act 1927, which has a parent act for the above bill, seeks to consolidate law relating to forest and transit the forest products. As has been discussed, the present bill seeks to amend the definition of trees by omitting the word bamboo from its definition under Section 2, Subclause 7. The person producing bamboos would no longer need state permits during transit and selling of bamboo in other states. Sir, there exist conflicts on the status of bamboo under different law. Our colonial era law, the Indian Forest Act 1927, classified bamboo as tree and fallen bamboo as timber. This was a contrary to the scientific classification of bamboo as grass, which our Honorable Minister have already mentioned. Had it been considered grass, bamboo would be exempted from many restrictions in cutting and transportation. Although we have a Forest Right Act 2006, which classifies bamboo as non-timber, states have largely applied restriction on bamboo transit in the line with 1927 Act. This brings me to another issue, sir. Some states in the country would have their own set of law governing forest. I would request here that the amendment does not affect state laws and rules. Thus, in all practical things, we may end up by seeing no change on how bamboo is transported or sold. I wish to ask the government whether states have been given the freedom to decide whether permits for bamboo movement are required, or are the states expected to follow the amendment being moved if passed by the House? There is a need for simultaneous change in the law of all states to avoid any further uncertainties. This would reduce the burden on farmer, for whom the main source of livelihood is bamboo production. Sir, India has the largest area under bamboo cultivation and is the second richest in terms of bamboo genetic resource after China. This will generate the demand for raw material leading to plantation of bamboo tree on non-forest land, providing employment and encourage growth of small and medium industry in the village and small towns also. Sir, according to my understanding of the text of the bill, the amendment pertains only to the definition of trees. However, according to the statements of the object and reasons, the amendments need the order to exempt bamboo grown on the non-forest land. I would like to ask from Honorable Minister, why is the amendment not drafted to that extent to shed light on the aspect of deregulation of bamboo for non-forest lands? Is this a patent drafting error from the side of government, or an attempt to make unsane changes in law? I request the government to make change to clarify this position. Also, sir, most bamboo production occur within the forest land where SC/ST people reside. How are we supporting the cause of helping the farmers if they are not there, if they would not still get the benefit of it? The government should ponder over a solution on the same. The solution should be in a line with environmental consideration and farmers' welfare. Sir, bamboo has over 1,500 documented uses varying from tube lights to aircraft manufacturing. India has about 30% of bamboo resources. However, our market share is a global market remaining roughly about 4%. Sir, the bamboo sector employs 10 million people, which has the capacity to employ 50 to 129 million people. Sir, the need is to harness the domestic and the global potential of the bamboo use to increase the income of the farmers. Lastly, I would like to reiterate the disapproval of the process of enacting the bill. Through you, I urge the government to control its desire of issuing ordinances time and again. This is the effect of bypassing the parliament's again lawmaking power. Sir, the ordinances are becoming an alternate tool of the legislation under the present government. With these words, thank you, sir.
Thank you.